Hello, this is Glenn Hall Taylor. What you are about to hear is an original Sherlock Holmes radio show, which was broadcast live in the mid-40s. It was my pleasure to act as producer-director of this series, which starred Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce. Before we hear the first of these shows, I'd like to tell you a little about what it was like at that time in live radio, and also a little about Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce. Sherlock Holmes show, there was no doubt about it. This was a powerful show. Everybody who listened to radio seemed to know about it, unless they were limited to the New York Philharmonic and Town Hall Tonight. The program listeners knew the show. It was famous. It was a famous show. I think it was a very strong show. You know, one time we did an audition in which Nigel Bruce played the part of a retired Scotland Yard inspector. And we did this half-hour audition, and at the end of the audition, the announcer said, "This is the Mutual Broadcasting System." And Nigel Bruce turned to me and says, "Oh, dear boy, what's the Mutual Broadcasting System?" I said, "You've been on it for 2 years for Petri Wine." He had been on the show all this time and had never noticed what the closing announcement was. One of the best ways to listen to dramatic radio is to turn out the lights, sit back, and let your imagination take over. I'm going to do that right now myself. Won't you please join me?
This episode from the life of Sherlock Holmes will be transmitted to our men and women overseas by shortwave and through the worldwide facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. Petri Wine brings you Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce in the new adventures of Sherlock Holmes. The Petri family, the family that took time to bring you good wine, invite you to listen to Dr. Watson tell about another exciting adventure he shared with his old friend, that master detective Sherlock Holmes. And say, I want to ask you if you've sent in for that little present we've got for you. You know, that swell recipe calendar. It's free, of course, and it's really something. It's a 2-year calendar for 1945 and 46, and it's beautifully done in full color. But the best part of it is that it's jammed with recipes and ideas for cooking with Petri wine. Send for your free recipe calendar tonight. Just send your name and address to Petri Wine, P-E-T-R-I, Petri Wine, San Francisco 26, California. San Francisco 26, California. The requests for this swell calendar have been coming in so fast that you better hurry up and get yours before we get snowed under. Write tonight, and we'll send you your free recipe calendar at once. And now for our weekly visit with the good Dr. Watson. Let's see if he's waiting for us.
Come in. Come in.
Oh, good evening, Doctor. Playing the phonograph, I see.
Yes, my boy. And that particular melody has some very potent memories for me. Here, I'll turn the thing on. You haven't come here to listen to a Mozart sonata. You want a story, don't you, young fellow, my lad?
That's right, Doctor.
Well, let's sit down.
All right.
That's better. Now I'll tell you what.
Oh, thank you, Doctor.
Began in Vienna in 1889, many, many years before the insane house painter named Schickelgruber had converted that gay city into a place of fear and oppression.
And what were you and Sherlock Holmes doing there, Doctor? Just taking a trip?
Mr. Foreman, in those early days of our association, we didn't have the time or the money for just taking trips. No, we were in Vienna because Holmes had been engaged in certain highly important investigations. We were staying in a charming little pension inhabited by students and musicians. And on the night this story began, we'd finished dinner and had returned to our room. I was busy making some notes on the investigation we'd just concluded. And Holmes was scraping away at his beloved violin.
Oh, confound it. What's wrong? Why can't I get it?
Oh, it sounds very pretty to me.
Pretty, really, old chap. Ah. I'm an amateur. And a heavy-fingered one at that. Listen to this. Sounds like a fiddler at an Irish wake.
Oh, take it easy, Holmes. Take it easy. There's no need to fling the violin down like that.
What's an old chap? Why, with all your other excellent qualities, are you not a pianist?
What's a piano got to do with it?
In this case, everything. There's a piano in this room, and if you could play it, the Mozart sonata I'm struggling with might have some meaning. Come in.
Oh,
good evening, Fräulein. You wish to see me?
You are Herr Sherlock Holmes.
That is my name.
Then, ja, I wish to see you. I am Leo Uhlenstein. I live here in this pension.
How do you do? Now, this is my friend, Dr. Watson.
How do you do, Herr Doctor?
I'm glad to meet you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.